Krishna Prasaya Bhutale Himate Bhakti Vedanta Samiti Nahide
Hare Krishna. कभी भी तुम्हारे साथ में कुछ नहीं जाएगा और तुम्हारे परिवार का कोई भी साथ नहीं जाएगा। इसलिए गधे के समान में परिश्रम न करके जीवन निर्वाह के लिए करो और जो कुछ भी करो भगवान को प्रसन्न करने के लिए। तो भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर जी का एक प्रकार से कहना है कि इनमें आसक्त न हो, ये आसक्त ही समस्त अनर्थों का मूल है। गुरु पदाश्रय करके भजन करने से अनर्थ निवृत्ति होती है, इसके बाद में निष्ठा होती है, इसके बाद में चतुर्थ स्थल में रुचि हुई, रुचि के बाद में आसक्ति हुई, आसक्ति के बाद में भाव हुआ छ, और आसक्ति के बाद में विप्रलम्बमयी प्रेम होता है, और आठवें में संभोग रूपी प्रेम होता है। यही अष्टकालीय लीला में राधा कृष्ण के नित्य मिलन में जो अष्टकालीय लीला है उसमें प्रवेश करने का अधिकार ये मिलेगा ग्रंथ। इसलिए इसको खूब अच्छी तरह से सुनने और समझने का प्रयास करेंगे, प्रयास करते हुए जाते भजन राज्य प्रवेश करें। भजन कच्ची ना पहले की हमें एक्टिंग नदी आती तहां धारा आती, धारा मध्य प्रवाह था, आज के प्रवाह मध्य एक आने के आते चंचल वो दो तीन दिन पर एक उठाए चले जाए प्रयाग का प्रयाग ठीक है समुद्र चले जाए एक प्रवाह हमारे भजन प्रवाह थे। क्रमे क्रमे हमें देखो भजन करे गुरु निष्ठा हो ना हमारे लक्ष्य गुल धीरे धीरे दूर हो ना हमार संसार प्रति स्त्री प्रति पति प्रति को आसक्ति आना यहाँ जचाई करते हैं देखते आप नामे दिए कि हरिकथा श्रमण के रुचि हो देखो जी आसक्ति हो बिना कथा सुने थे संसारिक आसक्ति संपूर्ण रूप से नष्ट हो तत्पश्चात भाव उदित हो गए विपर्लम्ब भाव ना परे कोई अष्टकालीय लीला सब उदित धारा प्रवाह मध्य यदि हमारे इच्छा ना हो ताले बुझे जो गलत आ गलत पोथा भूल जाएगा हाँ गुरु मध्य गलत आते हमारे ठीक डिरेक्शन दिखे अथवा हमारे मध्य आते यदि वही रकम बुद्धि के हमारे निष्ठा रुचि सब आते किंतु हमारे उन्नति हो तक बुझे जो गुरु मध्य बुझे दोष है तक कहा के प्रणाम करे कहा आदेश दिए को शिक्षा दो उन्नत तार का আর যদি ওখানে ঠিক আছে আমার মধ্যে গলত থাকে তাহলে এইটাকে সুধার ক্রমে 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 একেবারে প্রেম অবস্থা তক পৌঁছা যায় চেষ্টা করবে নচিৎ অন্তত ভাবাবস্থা তাকে এই মনুষ্য জন্মেতে পৌঁছে গেলে কোন তার হয়ে আর মনকে আবার আসবা সহজেই অতএব আপনারা খুব ভালো কাউকে শুনবেন আর এটাকে পালন করবেন এইটা জীবনে পুঁজি আপনার পকেটে হৃদয়তে নিয়ে বাড়ি
Yesterday we finished commentary on Srimad-Bhagavatam last ago. But still, at Parvati Brat, we will continue the chanting every morning. But from now on, the morning time, we will hear from Sri Thakur Bhaktivinoda, Sri Bhajan Rahasya. Especially those who desire to perform Bhajan, they should understand what is this Bhajan Rahasya? Rahasya means confidential or secret thing. So we should hear very carefully and try to understand what is Bhajan Rahasya, the confidential truth of Bhajan. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, with his own hand, has written 8 verses. That is Sri Sikshati. In his Bhajan Rahasya, there is an explanation of Sri Thakur Bhaktivinoda of this Sikshastikam of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Also, Krishna's pastimes are divided into 8 divisions or 8 yam, Asta yam. In the daytime there are 3, in the nighttime there are also 3, and in the sandhyas, in the joining of morning and in the morning time and the evening time, there is also 2. So 3 plus 3 plus 2 is 8 yams. Especially the Gaudiya Vaishnavas, with their siddha deha, their internally conceived spiritual body, they always remember these 8 periods of Krishna's pastimes and engage in service to them. There are how to do, that is all explained in this Bhajan Rahasya. The 8 divisions of Krishna's pastimes are Nishant Lila, Pratakala, Purvana, Madhyanila, Sayanila, Pradoslila, Naisalila, and then again Vishantalila. So just as there are 8 verses in Chikshastikam, as there are 8 divisions of Krishna's pastimes, there have also been 8 stages of attainment of devotional service, as we have been hearing Adol Shraddha Tathasava Sangha. First there is Shraddha, or faith. By that faith, one takes shelter of a bona fide guru and begins the process of devotion, which is called the Bhajana Kriya. By that Bhajana Kriya, one experiences anatta nivritti, or cessation of disturbing elements. What is anatta? Anatta. Atta means which is valuable. Anatta, which has no value. Therefore, forgetting Krishna's service, that is the real anatta. That manifests in considering in conceptual I and mine. I am this body and what belongs to this body in terms of wife, wealth, children, house, this belongs to me, this for my enjoyment. This is the root of all anathas. By this we think, by accumulating money, I will be happy. But do not think like this. By attachment to wealth, one will simply take birth again and end up like a snake, because snake always protects his wealth. One will be like Kuvair, sitting on his money. Therefore, we should accumulate enough wealth which is sufficient to maintain the body. Because at the time of death, we will not take even 1 rupee with us, or to speak of family members. We should not be like donkeys, simply carrying a heavy load with no benefit to ourselves. Therefore, whatever we do in this world, we should do for the happiness and the service of Bhagavan. We should have no attachment, and this attachment is the root cause of all other anattas, or unwanted desires. Therefore, after anatta nivritti comes nishta, fixed determination, ruchi, taste, ashakti, attachment, bhava bhakti, then the phone went off, I couldn't hear, then viraha, then some vipralabha prem, then some bodh meeting. Therefore, by hearing very carefully this Bhajan Rahasya, we will attain the qualification to enter into all of these things, especially the Astakali Lila of Radha and Krishna. Therefore, here, and not only here, we try to understand the subject matter and try to enter it. In a flowing river that is also called a dhara, the water current. Therefore, what water is there today now, after 2 or 3 days, will go anywhere, even to Allahabad Prayag, means it always moving. Therefore, our bhajan should be like this. It should always be progressing. Therefore, we should try and understand whether really our anathas are going, is nistra appearing, are we still maintaining attachment to women? Do we have taste in taking the name or in hearing Harikata? If one has developed attachment to hearing Harikata, then definitely all anathas or unwanted desires will be completely destroyed. Then after this, one will easily achieve Bhava Bhakti. Therefore, despite all this, there may be some hope. Even though we may have good nishtha in performing the limbs of devotion, we are not improving, then it could be the fault is in the spiritual master, the Diksha Guru. In that case, one should take shelter of a high class of Shiksha Guru. And if Shiksha Guru is okay, and still we are not advancing, then must be the hole is in us, the fault is in us. Therefore, we should endeavor to increase our devotion and steadily, steadily progress towards the stage of Prema Bhakti. Therefore, this Bhav Bhakti is most difficult to achieve. And having achieved the stage of Bhav Bhakti, all these unwanted anathas and desires will never return. Therefore, here, and here, and try to follow nicely and carry this with us, with you always in your hearts.
Ghat amra jabo, otake brahma haro.